Listen, I need to start this video by saying this is going to be quite a sensitive video, a video where the topic is quite, sensitive. So it's kind of like a, I don't know what you call it, like a pre-warning, like a hazard warning or some shit. You know, this is a sensitive topic. So, you know, if abortion and things like that is something that you don't want to talk about, then obviously click away from the video. But yeah, if you do want to see what we're talking about today, then stay tuned. So yeah, we're back with another video. Yeah, so as always, subscribe to the channel, give the video a thumbs up at the end of the video if it makes sense or you like it and all that stuff. So yeah, now the fundamentals are out of the way, let's get it started. Early in the morning. As you can tell by the title's video's title, I always do that. As you can tell by the video's title, you can probably work out my opinion on this already. I firmly believe abortion is a woman's right to choose. And abortion should be legal for everyone. It's something that two people should be able to come to an agreement with, a man and a woman, and they should go ahead and do whatever they feel is necessary at the time. And I've got nothing wrong with that at all. The only reason I'm doing this video today is because I get notifications on my phone from like the Telegraph, and like, I didn't even set that up. I don't know why these newspaper articles come through to my phone. Anyway, it worked this time. I saw an article and about, well, a number of states in America have basically legalized or illegalized abortion beyond 6 weeks, and they've called it the heartbeat bill. The idea behind it is that the second that the fetus has a heartbeat, which usually is around 6 weeks, it's illegal to abort it. Now, I was reading this article, and women apparently don't even know they're pregnant most of the time until, say, the 9 week mark when they get morning sickness and things like that. You know, a lot of women don't find out until way after 6 weeks. So there's a big problem with that, and it means it takes the power away from the woman or the couple or whoever it is. There's a number of reasons why I think women and couples should be allowed to abort a child, and the reason is because a couple may not be financially capable to raise a child. Now, when a child is brought into this world, I'm not a father, so I don't know, but I'm a human, so I know, you know, when a child comes into this earth, as the parent, are no longer the priority of your own life. You know, you now have to look after and fund, finance everything, and grow, help mature, shape, develop another human being. We're not like animals when they can be born and they can run already and fly and shit. We are very, very vulnerable as babies, and we need to be able to like have the patience and have the foundations to help that baby grow and mature and keep it alive. You know, That's not a joke. Like some people, in my opinion, when they get pregnant at a young age, I don't think they realize the gravity of the situation they found themselves in. And I think they want to prove to the world that they can do it and they can be a single a parent or whatever it is, a single mother, when it's not a game, it's not a joke. You know, people should have the right to choose to spare themselves from that if they're not ready. That's financial stability, yeah, for me, is number one. Secondly, if this bill really does get pushed out to the wider America, right, or even the wider Western countries and societies, that's not gonna stop abortions. And like I said, I'm not an expert on these things here yet, but if women have been used to having the freedom to choose whether they want to terminate the pregnancy, they're going to find alternative ways to get rid of it. It's that simple. And if you limit someone's options, you're pushing them into a darker avenue of getting rid of that baby. Now, we in a modern society should just give people the right to choose, because you know it's safe, you know it's fair, you know it's not dangerous, for example. Well, that's opposite of safe, but yeah, you know it's not dangerous. We control it rather than back alley abortion clinics or something, the rise of that. You know, the same could be argued for like legalizing drugs, for example. If you legalize it, then the whole drug empire collapses and people aren't making money off people's misery. You know, that's the same thing could happen if abortion is illegal, because people are still gonna find ways to do it. If people aren't ready to have a baby, they're not gonna have it. And it's a shame, because people could permanently damage their bodies going to back alley clinics and things like that. It doesn't make sense to take away people's options. But another reason why we should support a woman's right to choose is the fact that if you have a child, no matter what age you are, you could be a 16-year-old girl, you could be a 24-year-old girl. If you have a child, you may limit your options for a potential life partner. Now, I'm not saying that if I met a woman with a child, I would turn my back on her because it's not my child. No, I'm not saying that. To be honest, if I love someone, then I love the child as well. But a lot of people might not. You know, that's real talk, that's facts. A lot of people might not want a woman with a baby from a previous relationship or one night stand or anything. And now that woman is limiting her life partner choices because she's been stuck with a baby that she didn't actually want. And I know it sounds dark and I know it sounds kind of cruel, but this is actually straight talking facts. This is how real life works. And I'm trying not to shy away from the darker topics because these are real life outcomes. I don't really know how pregnancy cycles work, but it's of my belief that until the baby's actually in the world, then a woman has the right to choose what to do with it. Now, I'm not saying you can get an abortion, you know, 8 months down the line. Maybe there should be a threshold. Maybe there should be a limit. You know, I don't know what it is. I don't know how the cycles work. I don't know if it's 6 months or whatever, but 6 weeks, that's too early. That's too early. And you know, what could happen to that mum now she has a baby? If she, for example, terminated that pregnancy, she then opens up her doors for more prospects. It could be she can fund her college tuition or whatever if you're in America, or you can fund something else, or you can get a job, whatever. But if it's illegal and she has to have that baby and she's not financially secure, she hasn't got a house of her own, she still lives at home, she's still a child herself, whatever it is, do we think her life is going to be better for having this baby? Do we think the baby's life is going to be better for being born? I think it's all about perspective. I don't think you're murdering a child when you have an abortion. And some people obviously do feel that. And clearly when there's a heartbeat or something at 6 weeks, then clearly that's enough for some people. I think we should be looking at the bigger picture. We should be looking at the woman who's actually pregnant. What it could happen, what having that baby could do to her physically, in her life, mentally. We should be looking at actually a woman's right to choose, a couple's right to choose, and we're not living in a totalitarian regime where we control what people can do with their lives and things like that. You know, I don't think we should be able to do that. I don't think we should control that. I think everyone should have a control of their own life. But listen, I don't know. I just thought that because we were modernizing, we were developing, that we wouldn't go backwards in terms of, okay, abortion was illegal, then we've legalized it, we've justified it, and now we're gonna make it illegal again, which could actually have an adverse effect on everyone's life involved. I don't know. For me, it's glaringly obvious that we should support someone's right to choose, but listen, it's a divisive topic. I hope I ain't pissed. I don't really want to piss no one off. This is just my opinion. So yeah, bit of a dark one today. Not too many laughs and that, but it's something that we have to talk about, especially our generation. I'm 24, listen, and I'm in a generation where everyone's sexually active. And I'm not saying that everyone should just be active, get pregnant and get abortions. You know, that's not good for the body, that's not good for the mind. But, you know, everyone has the right to their own body and their own life. That's my opinion. So anyway, like I said, I hope I ain't pissed no one off. Subscribe to the channel, support the channel. I'm gonna get some friends involved very soon because I wanna have a dynamic. You know, I wanna get a dynamic with, you know, other people involved, maybe a little podcast type vibe or a little, I don't know, I got a few girls and a few boys that want to come through. So yeah, anyway, stay tuned for a little more collaboration coming up, and peace.